Section 13.0, Troubleshooting the PI System. Well, when troubleshooting the PI system, or really troubleshooting anything for that matter, the first thing to do is to try to isolate the problem. Is it a client problem? Is there a problem with the network? Do other things work on the network? Are there updates that are not working on the interface, or is it instead on the PI server? Now, a good way to distinguish between the two, between an interface and a PI server problem, is to look at the value of the tag sinusoid. If you have not, if you chose to install those default tags like sinusoid, then if you have historical values and current values for sinusoid, the problem is probably going to be with your interface. See, sinusoid, if you're having problems and sinusoid is not available, then that would be an indication of a general kind of an archive failure or a network failure. But if it's just your certain interface tags and this is working fine, then you've isolated this to be associated with that interface. Now also, take a look at the server and the client log files. I've mentioned this before, but probably the single best place to go for our or for troubleshooting the client applications is to go into Program Files, and within there, PyPC, and then in the DAT directory. So within the DAT, you'll find PyPC.log. So just about any kind of a client problem is going to be reflected there. And then likewise, if you go into the PI System, System Management Tools, look in Operations and look at the message log. So we store just about everything that goes on in the PI system. We store just about everything there. You know, even things that, well, you might not imagine. So there's a huge amount of data that you'd find within that message log. Okay. And then the other thing to check is, you know, check your performance monitor tags, your IO rate tags. What do they look like? Are you actually, you know, is your IO actually consistent with what you'd normally expect? So take a look at those things. Here are some questions we suggest you ask yourself when you are in a troubleshooting session. First, check all the things, the components on the server. So, you know, take a look at some of these things. We're not going to go through all of them all now, but, you know, are the services running? Have you looked at the Windows event log, etc.? Okay. If it's an interface problem, take a look at this section here. And if it's a client problem, you know, take a look here. A lot of these things are very common sense troubleshooting. Like, for example, can you check the suspected bad component against, you know, good other good components? Now, another resource you should check out is this is in the PI Server System Management Guide. It's a troubleshooting checklist. Now, this checklist started out as a kind of a checklist for our tech support folks. Just to kind of those who are new, just to try to get a handle on some of the problems. And I've noticed if I'm kind of stumped by a problem and I just go through this checklist one at a time, about half the time it seems like the problem jumps right out at me. So there's a lot of good advice packed in this checklist. For example, testing out API snap from a remote node and then also from the home node. See, these are two different ways of checking to see if the communications are working. So for example, if you're using PyConfig and that works, but API snap does not work, that's an indication you've got some kind of an API or a network problem. So give that task list or that checklist a try. Another thing to do is to simply look at the task manager. So for example, let me go over to the PI server, and within the PI server you can choose the task manager and just look at the CPU usage. Look at the amount of CPU that you're getting for each of your processes and check this on a daily basis. And a lot of system management is simply checking the same utilities over and over again to see which ones seem to be acting up. And of course, if you have created any performance tags, this would be a good time to go in and look at those performance points, the IO rate tags, etc. An excellent utility that's very simple to use is pisnap. You can run this on the PI home node. Now, if I run on this this Pi server, if I run pisnap, that's simply doing what we call an API snap to localhost. And from there, we can type in the name of a Pi tag, and we can take a look at what its status is as far as the snapshot value goes and the archive value. So sometimes this can be very useful, because if the snapshot's there and the archive isn't there, you know you simply have some kind of an archive problem. It can help you isolate where the problems may be. And another utility you can use is within the this would be within the system management tools under operation. You'll find that there is a set of snapshot and archive statistics that you can look at and update. So, for example, what I did just now, I took a look at both the snapshot and the archive metrics here, and they are updating once every 5 seconds. So this 5 second update is showing me the values in the last 5 seconds, and this column over here shows me the values since the last time I stopped and restarted Pi. So this can be interesting if you see a lot of things like out of order events in either the snapshot or the archive. That's an indication that somehow you're getting data that's coming in out of the normal time series, and that's something that's really worth worth looking at. Now from here, there's certain specific things to look for. For example, the archive backup flag. If that's set equal to 1, that means that a backup is probably in progress or has perhaps failed and left the archive offline. Also, if you notice the events sent to the queue, and that event sent to queue just does not continue to update, then that may mean that you've got some kind of an archive problem. And in that case, the events in the queue are going to keep growing and growing. So watch out for that. The this would be an indication that there's some kind of a event or a buffer that's filling on the home node because the archive is not able to meet the performance of or the demand. So you would see that by looking at this events in queue and the number of overflow queues. Now, the first line of defense in doing any troubleshooting is the message logs, the system manager message logs that we store on the Pi server. So here's what it looks like. We've used it a great deal in this class so far. So I would simply go into operation and message logs. And this is where I would go through and search through the message logs. Again, you can look through the local pipc.logs as well. Now, the second place to go, in addition to the message logs, where you'd find those server-based messages, is to look in pipc.log. Probably one of the easiest ways of bringing that up is using ICU, Interface Configuration Utility. I still find this is the easiest, most intuitive way of opening this file. So you go into Tools, and within Tools, go into Log Files, and you're going to be looking for this file and all the older versions of that file. Yeah, see Tools, Log Files. I can see the latest pipc.log. Okay. So this holds the messages for all the API-based applications, and of course that's going to include interfaces on a remote node. Okay. On the server node, it's generally going to include all the standard Pi interfaces like perfmon and random, etc. Okay. So you can use Notepad, as we saw, to edit this. You can also choose Continuous, which brings up that watch log, and just watch it continually. If you do find a specific error message in the log files, then by all means go into the support site, and within the support site you can choose to search for those message logs. So for example, -10701 is going to have a specific meaning, and the more specific an error message, the better your chances of finding somebody that's seen that problem as well. So this describes some of those instances. Okay. Also, if you are making use of the SDK-based clients, and this is on a remote node, not on the Pi server, but if you're using SDK-based clients like Processbook and Datalink, then you will find that there is a log that is generated in a log directory. that is searchable only by that PI System Management Tools message log plugin. Okay. You can also use PI get message from the DOS prompt in the PIPC/admin directory. But the again, the better tool would be to use the message log plugin, and you can open that file manually. So you'll be able to open up log files and also other types of the log and the dat files that we use for some types of message logging.